What's going on, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we have a fun install. We have a whole bunch of stuff to put on the car today, so I'm really stoked. So let me show you what I got. So first up, we have the ETS intercooler. This is a, I believe, 4-inch deep intercooler. We have an ETS stencil for it and some blue spray paint, but I'm not sure if I want to go with the blue spray paint just yet. I'm going to put it on the car and see what it looks like, and I might just end up doing black because this intercooler is silver. We also have some ETS hard intercooler piping, all the connectors for it, all the clamps, and then some hardware in there as well. For the intercooler, we have a ZunSport bottom grill right here. So this is pretty heavy duty stainless steel. And compared to the cars, this is stainless as well, but it's kind of like a little flimsy. I just wanna make sure when the intercooler is on the car, it doesn't get all nicked up and a whole bunch of dings. So this should help just a little bit. We have the big mouth intake right here. So what this does, it just sits in right here in the car and connects up to the OEM mounting brackets to help air get into the intake. And then, oh, almost forgot, some anti-flicker modules. So when I put the fog lights in, these had like a little bit of a flicker on them. So I picked these up and hopefully that takes away the flicker, but when the bumper's off, I might as well throw these in because it's gonna be really simple. Only a couple little clips and you are done. So without further ado, let's start the install. First things first, we're gonna put an intercooler on, gotta take the front bumper off. I'm gonna jack the car up on both sides so I have some room underneath there to take the clips off, and then I'll take the whole front bumper off. We have the bumper off right here. Now while it was off, I threw in those CAN bust little anti-flicker modules right there. I plugged it in, made sure they work, everything works fine. And then while we have this off, all this useless plastic right here, and then this thing, crash bar guard, all that I'm gonna take off. And then if you would look up here, you may notice I have the stock intake back on. So I bought a new cowl. This one's obviously not cut, so that's pretty much OEM. And then we have the stock filter on here. I'm not gonna tell you exactly why we did that just yet, but if you look over here to the hard intercooler pipes, you might be able to take a guess why. Got the big mouth installed in the nitrous blue. Next up, I'm going to install this bottom grill piece right down here. There we go, just three little tabs here, here, and there. I oriented mine going straight up and down. I think it looks a little bit better than sideways. Still kind of hard to see, but that should reinforce it a ton. Now under the intercooler, right here, there's a clamp right here. There is a map sensor. I believe it's a map sensor on top of the intercooler itself. And then on the other side, same thing right here. Take that off. And then we should be able to just pull this intercooler right off and slide it out of these little mounts. This is the charge pipe, the OEM one that came out of the car. Right there is the new one. And then to the turbo, you're gonna have one of these. It's kind of, it's bigger down here and smaller up here. The smaller end right here, that's gonna go to the turbo. You can see out of all of these big ones, there's one little small one that goes on here, just like that. That's gonna go to the turbo, and then this bigger piece is gonna go to that new one where it 90s up. It is the next day, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I got super mad trying to install this, so I just put the camera down. My buddy Evan came over, gave me a hand with it. But so far what we have obviously the snorkel installed. We put the intercooler on, all the hard pipes. I'll go underneath the car and I'll show you guys all about the hard pipes, how I did it, and all that kind of stuff. But when we got that installed, I spray painted on the ETS logo on the front of the intercooler. And then one more thing too. So in my room, I had this grill laying around and I seen somebody on an RS forum install this. And I think he's the only one that I've seen that's actually done it, because you do have to cut your bumper up. But this is a full mesh grill right here, the very top. So what you had to do was cut this RS out You have to cut the piece of plastic behind it out. But what I've done is right here, I put rib nuts on each one of these. There's three in the bottom and two in the top. Drill the hole and put a screw. These are just holding it in place right now. I'm gonna get shorter screws for it and then make two brackets for this hole right here. And then this will be secured to the plastic on the bumper. But so far it's coming out really good. I'm super excited. I'll give you guys a front view of it really quick. So it's gonna open it up a ton. With this factory crash bar I have right here, you can see in the middle, it's kind of not black. There's kind of a little bit of paint missing right there. So I'm gonna get the TB crash bar eventually and then mount my intercooler to that. And I'm gonna get the black one, so it's gonna be a super clean look and you can see it through the mesh grill. But other than that, I'll go into the car and I'll show you guys the hard intercooler pipes. Starting off with the intercooler right here, we have obviously that sensor up top and then the boot right here with this little clamp. This was one of the hardest parts to get in, trying to get the intercooler and the hard pipe connector matched up. And then same on this side, that was super difficult. I just used a ton of silicone spray. I just lobbed a whole bunch in there, so it was super slippery. And then eventually it did end up popping on, and then I just tightened this down. So underneath the car, this is the passenger side hard pipe right here. You can see that right here is the 90 degree coupler. And then it comes up here, it mounts to the AC condenser or AC compressor, and then up to the intake manifold. And then on the driver's side, right here, it's all hard, pretty much all the way up to the intercooler. This is all hard pipes, and then there's just a couple connectors right here. And then it goes underneath here, there's two mounting points underneath the engine. And then it comes up here, and then that's what I said was the like reducing coupling right here. It goes to the hard pipe to the turbo, and that is a different size. So this side was actually really easy to install. The part that goes up to the intake manifold, that was kind of a pain to get in. That's when I kind of lost it a little bit, but we got everything installed now. And then last but not least with this intercooler, obviously you have to mount it to the frame. There's two holes right here and right there. And then underneath the intercooler, right here you can see that's a mount for it. It goes on top, and then same on this side, mount right there, and it sits on top. I did figure out putting this in, it's easier if you do not have the tops connected. You just kind of put it in at the same time, like push it down a little bit on an angle, then kind of push it in with a whole bunch of silicone spray, and then it should be going on pretty easy. But since this is all done now, I'm gonna wait for Evan to come over. We're gonna run to the store and then finish up making these little brackets for here, and then we should be 100% done. Well, Evan just left. We are all finished up, as you can see.
We have the ETS intercooler right here. There's the intake snorkel. I put a little bit of spray paint on the crash bar because there's a couple spots that weren't painted. And then the grill came out awesome. Super happy about that. So for these, right here on both sides, we have two little screw holes. I went to the store and bought some Allen keys, some black Allen bolts, because I think they look pretty clean. I made some little brackets right here. I made kind of like an obtuse L bracket out of some stock aluminum. I just scraped it down, spray painted them black, and you can't really see them, and they're hidden pretty well. I think it came out really awesome. If you guys do this, just make sure, you know, you do one side first, get it all bolted in, and then work on the other side. Just so you know, this side's all secure and not gonna move on you when you're working on that one.
All in all, this wasn't too bad to do. There's a couple places that made me kind of mad, and it's probably gonna make you pretty mad too doing it, but you just gotta take your time, slow down, make sure you put the couplers on, everything's tight when you finish up. And then last but not least, right here, we have the Australia gel badges. They are pretty expensive, but these are the best badges I've had so far. On the ST, I had some stickers for the badges, and I'm not gonna lie, they're kind of junk. So I went with Australia badges. These are actually gel. Has super good adhesive on it, so we have one right here. And then also on the front grill, there is the RS badge that was on the cross arm, or the cross middle section. I did take it off, and I did put the nitrous blue gel badge on it, so I'm gonna, next time I take this bumper off, which is probably gonna be for a TB crash bar behind this, I'm going to epoxy some screws on the back of the badge, put it through here, these little holes in the grill, and then put a nut on the back, so we're gonna have a badge back on this. But other than that one, right here on the wing, you can see that looks super clean. super clean. It's the nitrous blue, and it goes right in the groove where the RS little indent was at. And then on the back, we have this one and this one. So when you put these on, they say to put a piece of tape over it for 2 to 3 hours afterwards. So these are the only ones that are kind of like on a weird angle, so they could come off. Like this one right here, you can see it's kind of like on a 45. So I'm not too worried about that one coming off, but these I'm a little concerned. So I just put some tape over it for now. But like I said, other than that, this is pretty much 100% done. Everything's put back together, and I can't get over how cool this is. That looks awesome. So that's gonna be the video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Like always, I'll leave a link in the description so you guys can pick it up for yourself. But other than that, I hope you enjoyed the video. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.